Let's paint the town. We'll shut it down. Let's burn the roof.
And then we'll do it again.
Let's do it. Let's do it. Let's do it. Let's do it. Tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. A feeling. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. A feeling. Tonight's the night. Let's live it up.
Let's live it up.
I got my money.
Hey,
let's spin it up.
Let's spin it up.
Go out and smash.
Smash it.
Like on my god.
Like on my god.
Jump out that sofa.
Come on.
Let's kick it off. Fill up my cup.
Drink.
Mazel tov.
L'chaim.
Look at her dancing.
Move it, move it.
Just take it off. Let's paint the town.
Paint the town.
We'll shut it down.
Shut it down.
Let's burn the roof.
And then we'll do it.
Finally, ladies and gentlemen, we give you the concluding minutes of the 1985 National League Final, when Monaghan and Armagh were locked in a titanic battle, with Gene Sherry, Jerry McCarville, Fergus Caulfield, Bernie Murray and Ray McCarron, all from Scotstown in the thick of the action, and subs Jack McCarville and Brendan Began ready to join the fray. We cannot resist in waxing poetic. Bliss was it that morn to be alive, but to be young was very heaven. Cool as a cucumber on the line was team manager Sean McCaig. Even today, at a remove of over 25 years, the pulse quickens at the memories of those glorious years. Thanks, men, and thanks again for bringing such excitement to our lives.
Decided to have a go himself. And he goes all the way. Well, that was a splendidly taken point by Bernie Murray. Well, this is Bernie Murray. What a nippy player he is. Trying to find Hugo Clark and does so. No doubt about that would be a foul. Eamon McEnany running across to take this free. A chance for Monaghan to go 2 points in front. Eamon McEnany. Points to Armagh's 8 points. Here's Rafferty. This is Declan Flanagan. This is Kieran Murray. Tommy Cassidy. No, in fact, it's McCurry. Beyond the specified duration, and this will be another opportunity for Eamon McEnany from 40 metres out. Well, for a time it looked as if Armagh were getting very, very close indeed. They had a lot of opportunities, but now it's Monaghan's turn once again. Football League victory, but there's Armagh desperately seek to get back into this game. Now here's an opportunity for them. Here's Corvin. Can he hold on to it? Still Corvin going on. Oh, it hits the crossbar and goes over. Yes, it's a point. There you can see Aidan Short seeking out Johnny Corvin. and Corbin racing on and blasting the ball as it hit against the crossbar. It's so close, but yet Armagh get the point. So now we're back to 2 points in it, less than 5 minutes to go. Tremendous excitement here at Croke Park. There's number 19, Jimmy Kerr. Now it's Aidan Short. Here's Corbin. Short is calling for it. Corbin decides to send it in, hoping to try and find Seeley. Oh, that was agonizingly close. Somehow Paddy Linder just got a boot to it at the foot of the post. Well, you've got to say it, Armagh have been unlucky on several occasions this afternoon. Here's McEnany, just a gentle touch on for McCarron. Here's a chance of a goal. To go for a point. Well, as against 10 wides for Armagh in this game, Monaghan have only had 3 wides, so you can just see how well they've done with what possession they've had. Here's McEnany looking up, and it's going all the way over. Superb play by Eamon. So Armagh beaten All-Ireland finalists in 1953, again in 77, beaten National League finalists in 83. Going to lose yet again today on the big occasion, as Ray McCarron and Monaghan are welcomed. Jerry McCardle been mobbed by Monaghan supporters already, and somewhere in the middle of that a football match is taking place. The referee calls. To win the National Football League title. And so a marvellous victory by Monaghan. 1 goal and 11 points to Armagh's 9 points. You have to feel a little bit sorry for Armagh. They've lost so many times here at Croke Park on the big day. They had their opportunities this afternoon, but they let them all slip when it mattered. There you can see Gene Sherry, the Monaghan captain. A very happy man. He missed out last Sunday's replay because of injury, but was back to lead his men to an historic victory today.